Advances in Health, I'm Rebecca Stewart. Osteoarthritis. It is a debilitating condition, and arthritis itself affects 54 million Americans. But there is so much hope. Dr. Jeff Pravda is here today from the Connecticut Orthopedic Institute at Mid-State Medical Center. Thank you so much.
Morning.
You have really great props here today to sort of show us and give us a better look at what happens in what you call a partial knee replacement. This is robotic-assisted surgery. What are we looking at here?
Well, we're looking at a partial knee, a standard, what we call a unicompartmental or one-sided knee replacement, done for not just baby boomers, done for all age groups, but the baby boomers are more interested. Basically, this is a procedure that's done for a person who has arthritis on just one side of the knee, be it the inside or the outside. So we've left the outside the way it was, we've left the kneecap the way it was, and we've gone in and we've resurfaced or put a small metal cap on the edge of the femur bone. And the robot, as you mentioned, the robotic portion of this is that this area of bone is actually cleaned out or milled by the robot with us using the robot to assist us, and it's done with the computer.
And saving so much of that bone, why is that beneficial to a patient?
Well, you all save the ligaments and the bone, and this is the bone that tells the person where their body is in space. So the rest of this knee is left alone, so this will act more like a normal knee than a total knee where we've resurfaced or replaced the entire knee.
Best kind of candidate for a surgery like this?
Well, anybody with one-sided disease, that tends to be the more younger patient population, the aging baby boomer who's just worn out from too much tennis and basketball. Mm-hmm. You can do this procedure on both sides, but for the most part, it's somebody who has isolated one area of disease in the knee, the rest of the knee looks good or pristine.
All right, Dr. Jeff Pravda, thank you so much. For more information, log on to WTNH.com/advancesinhealth.